Now, verse 8 is for the rest of y'all that don't understand prosperity, don't understand how it works. We don't want to leave y'all out. We don't want to be racist in here, so we want to talk to you all, the rest of y'all up in here, who don't know how God's system works and got all your spiritual attributes and ideas about this ain't right, that's not right. Giving is the top of the list. You can put your receiving at the top of the list, but you ain't going to receive much. It's divine.
Yes, sir.
It governs God's blessing. Ooh, Jesus. Giving governs God. Write that down. Giving governs God's blessing in my life. Goodness. See this. See this, please. See this.
Amen.
See, and if these things here worry you, you sure at the right church. People put money in my hand and all that. I'm just showing you the magnetism of giving.
Amen.
You wonder why it happened to me? Because I'm a giver.
Right.
And I'm anointed to receive.
Right.
And all of these things are for a reason, for you to see how it works.
Mm-hmm.
There are those who haven't it happening to them right now. I'll tell you one. I'll call his name. Jeff Phillip.
Mm-hmm.
My son in the gospel.
Right.
Got a church in the hood.
Right.
And got people trained just like you are.
Right.
People giving left and right.
Right.
Jeff had no problem. Jeff, one of the biggest givers to me.
Right.
Jeff come to my house, stand in the yard, and said, can I see Pastor a minute?
Mm-hmm.
And they let him in the house. Me and two of my boys sitting down eating lunch. Jeff said to me, God told me to bring this to you.
$10,000.
Right. Mm-hmm.
He said, I was in Las Vegas walking down the street, and God said, get it in his hand quickly. May on this entire church a giving anointing be released. May on the internet a giving wave flow all over the world this morning, and knowing what they're doing and expecting divine results. I see nobody broke. I see nobody desire not being met. I see people moving into their dreams and vision. Because the giving anointing is about to open my way. You see it? Yes, 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 yes. Yes, pastors who listen to me, I see your church being paid off by the giving anointing. Find you some good soul and sow in. And stop all your strategies and conniving, man. Sow your way out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hey, I'm preaching myself happy, boy. Woo, glorious. Woo, glory to God. Sow your way out. Tell your neighbor. Now, I didn't say owe your way out. Some people trying to owe their way out. I heard the Holy Ghost say, tell them I didn't say owe your way out. That means borrow. I said, what? Sow your way out. Tell somebody else. Now, don't get in your mind, I want your money. I'm loaded. Don't get in your mind up here. I'm trying to get a dollar from you. I'm loaded. I got money. I don't know where it at. My money is spend friendly. When I see something I want, my money says spend me. So I don't want you to get no crazy ideas about, you know, working you up. I ain't trying to wake you up. I'm trying to get you up. Shoot. man, my uncle is something on you. Sit down. So I'm going to give you some principles from these texts when I read them. I'm just working the text as I go, because the Holy Ghost is so much. And you see, the disciples, they won't sell it. They ain't got no giving spirit. And then they won't give it to who? Poor. Poor had enough given to them already. With their poor self. The average poor person then got too many gifts. That's why they still poor. They still poor because people won't let them learn how to sow. Their hand like this all the time. In my lifetime, every person that I've taught to change that hand style, I saw their life change. Some I had to run off because they wasn't going to change. They just had that spirit in them. I tried to change them. They wouldn't change. They just got this. What you got for me? Lady said in the bank, lady turned her computer around at the desk. She said, this is what kind of interest we're paying. 0.05%? 0.05% on saving. That's what your money, that's what you're getting back. You ain't getting back no more than that, 0.05%. And then she said, on CDs, 0.09%. But yet, I have developed a $100 anointing because I sow hundreds like a dollar. And it come back to me in whops of hundreds. 40 hundred, all kind of $100 bills, just like I sowed it. Name your seed, God dog it. Name what you won't receive and sow it and it come back to you. You sow five, it come back in five. These are secrets I'm sharing. These are secrets I'm sharing, you see. So she was mocked to be blessed. There are seeds that you sow that mocks you to be blessed the rest of your life. There are lifetime blessing seeds. When you're under the anointing and God urged you to do it at that time, it may be a seed that mocked you the rest of your life. That's why I state, I'll never be broke another day in my life. You know why? I'm marked as a sower. I sow seeds in secret. I sow some open. Man said he's going to take my church. I can't meet the next payment. I just got in it. God said, that's your assignment. Ask him how much you need. He said, 30,000. I said, be in the mail in the morning. What I get back? I saved one of his churches. How long you think that seed gonna last? Rest of my life. They're putting your sand in that church. God said, send Leroy a harvest. God sometimes set you up for a seed. You got to keep your eyes open, children. You got to keep your eyes open. I'm paying attention to all them poor folks. You're going to have them with you always. They're always going to be there. You can help them when you get ready. But they're not no harvest people nowhere.
That's right. Amen.
You're just helping them. God said, I'll give you back what you give them.
That's what
he said. Yes, sir. He told for a memorial of her. Now, go to Mark 12 quickly. I'm going to give you some parameters. Go to Mark 12 quickly. I want to show you how this works. Because, you know, we get all hooked up on this expensive sowing. But I want to show you what Jesus is looking at in here this morning. You think Jesus is looking at your black and gold or your hair or something? Or what you got? Well, no, Jesus. You think Jesus is looking at your Bible, how you got it marked up? No, Jesus is watching you at offering time. Jesus is watching you at offering time. Jesus is watching you at offering time. Your money giving tell you where you at. Some of you lies up in here in this church and not tither. Then you talk about blessing. How can I bless what curse? You ain't making no more than $400. You won't give God $40. Because you poor, you see. The other person making $4,000. So, and the Lord don't expect me to give them no $40 off this. Look at her over there. She making $4,000 a month. I'm making $400. Stupid, how you think she got the 4,000?
Amen.
Now don't raise your hand, but I'm putting how many of y'all up in here not tithing? Any financial problem you got, if you're not tithing, that's where it come from.
Amen.
Now if you're tithing and you still got them, they're temporary.
Amen.
The tithes better go up in here this morning.
Amen.
Because I know some of y'all not tithing. giving Leroy my money. Stupid! This vision big enough for your tithe. Man sent his tithe from Germany. Man said, I ain't never heard nothing like this. Here's my tithe, brethren. He said, this is where I'm getting traded right now. But we said to them, your local church, you know, send your tithe to your local church. But if your local church not feeding you and you're looking for a church, go look for your church and send your tithe where you're getting fed at. You're supposed to pay your tithe where you get fed at. Here in Mark, now you're going to be just amazed here where Jesus is at now. I'm going to see if Jesus, then Jesus might be carnal. Jesus might be in the flesh, yeah. You know, he ain't hearing from God. You think there's any time, is a time anywhere? I'm talking to y'all over there. You think there's any time where Jesus didn't hear from God? Huh? Do you think there's a time that has come in Jesus' life that he wouldn't do what God would do? Huh? Now, you know, Jesus said, me and my Father one. It's not me that does the work. He says, the Word that does the work. So wherever Jesus said, that's where God said. All right. Verse 41 of the 12th chapter of Mark. This is what poor folks got to do. You there? Because I don't want you to miss verse 41. Read verse 41 with me. And Jesus, the treasury, and beheld how the people cast money into the treasury, and many that was rich cast in much. And it says, there came a certain what? No, it didn't say that. What kind? Didn't say poor. It didn't say poor. It can't be saying poor. There came a certain, and a double jeopardy, poor widow. She ain't nobody providing for her. And she threw in two mite, which make a fathering. And he called unto him. Well, he called him. Y'all come see, because they know they're full of unbelief. There's a question arising in my heart. How much do you have to sow?
Jesus.
What sowing break you waiting for? And it's the sowing that causes the breakthrough.
Amen.
Somebody waiting for a breakthrough to sow. Now I can tell you right now, from my personal life, I sowed my way out of lack.
Thank you, Lord.
I sold my way out of my small house.
Thank you, Lord.
I sold my way out of hangler suits.
Thank you, Lord.
From JCPenney.
Hallelujah.
Sold my way out. That's the only way you're going to get out.
Thank you, Lord.
Beyond your tithes.
You.
Oh, Lord, not Jesus. You talking about tithes? Now you're talking about beyond the tithes. Lord Jesus, this man going out of his mind. Sure is. I'm out of my mind. I'm out of my mind. I mean divine mind.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
If you listen to me.
Thank you, Lord.
If you don't let demonic forces upset your theology.
Glory to God.
And hear what the Spirit of God is saying. I'm telling you, there's a better life to live
thank
financially.
You, Lord. Thank you, Lord.